Everybody, it's Evicta. It's time for one of the most requested character runs here in The Binding of Isaac Repentance since Repentance came out. That's right. It is time for The Forgotten. I have not tried The Forgotten out in Repentance yet, so I'm very interested to seeing how he plays out. But first, here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by, I'm going to say, Klopixer, something like that. Title thread was, "We all love it. Indeed, you all do. Shoop. Duh. Whoop." Coral. I remember that episode of The Walking Dead when it came out for the first time, and it was quite entertaining. Today is going to be Yankee Golf 7 Alpha Deep. We've got, again, The Forgotten. Now, I talk about The Forgotten in a lighthearted tone because The Forgotten, as most of you know, is not one of my favorite characters, although I have heard tale that The Forgotten apparently in Repentance is quite strong, which is great. He doesn't play like any other iteration of Isaac at all. Melee weapon, has two forms, and is just overall very, very strong. But why would you not like him, Zinvicta? Well, I don't really like the playstyle. It was never something that I got too used to. And obviously with the streak going on, I didn't really have a chance to really dive deep into understanding how powerful The Forgotten is. Although I did do a short-lived but fun race series against Mathis, for those of you who remember that, and I never beat him. And maybe that kind of went into the reason why I didn't like The Forgotten all that much. But I digress. The Forgotten can be very powerful and is a lot of people's favorite character. And I really am curious to see how everything's going to work out in Repentance with The Forgotten. And I'm also very interested to see what kind of new synergies that you can get with the bone. And, of course, you also have the soul form. Saw right there. Got Big Chub. We might as well go into the store. Since Repentance came out, this first store that you all see on floor one will give you an automatic entry. And apparently, according to everybody yesterday during the Bethany run, the other Bethany run, the planetary item that I got out of that particular run was like one of the worst, apparently, according to people. Venus is not one of the most sought after planetary items in the game, so it's good to know. I'm not going to go into the final level. I guess we might as well. Okay. The Forgotten has two basic attacks. He's got the melee attack, and of course he also has the charged up, sort of like Mom's Knife-esque type attack. Now, one thing that is nice about The Forgotten is the fact that, of course, he does start with Bone Hearts, and it's one of the few times that you heard me, at least in Afterbirth Plus, say that Bone Hearts are going to be great. Now, I will say in Repentance, Bone Hearts are actually fantastic. The main reason why I did not like Bone Hearts when they first came out, up until through the conclusion of Afterbirth Plus, was simply just because of the fact that you can't get rid of them. But now you can in Devil Deals. They go straight into item room number two, and we've got the Dizzle. Wow. 11.95 damage. Good lord. That's a lot of damage, but no, our damage actually was not. It went up, but it didn't go up that much. Gotta be careful here. So when do you switch to the soul? When is the best time to do that? In my opinion, if you don't have a whole lot of stats to keep yourself safe, you generally do not want to switch to the soul unless if you know you're going to save yourself from getting a hit. Or if you don't have any red hearts on the floor, but you can get a lot of value out of the soul. It's the best way and easiest way to like ensure that you don't run out of HP. I saw that little schmoove there, Spider. Very high tears rate would help out The Forgotten greatly. We gain a whole lot of damage and a whole lot of tears rate, but we lost a lot of movement speed. So depending on how, I don't know, man. 7.07 damage is really good. Like, really, really good. That's shockingly good for this early on. And then, you know, going up to a 2.41 tier delay here, or swing delay, if you want to call it that, is quite powerful. But really what it's going to come down to, as always, is going to be how good are our Angel Deal items or our Devil Deal. I don't know what I thought would happen there, but it wasn't that. So we can get our Devil Deal. We might as well go check to see what's in there. Then we need to make a decision whether or not we're going to go into which extended run are we going to go into. So are we going to go towards Dogma, or are we going to go for the alternate path? I think we should go. We don't have anything interesting right now, but we do have a lot of HP, and we're playing as the Forgotten, so we might as well try the alternate path and head on down to Downpour. Now, I don't have high hopes for this run, in terms of us beating Mother. Unless if we get something that's really balling out of control, we are going to have some issues with Mother. I also don't know how, excuse me, I don't know how, well, there's our white fire already. I don't know how the Mother run is going to work. The witness run, or whatever. What do you want to call it? You know, when you have to go in the mines and all that stuff, this is going to be interesting with the Forgotten. I mean, Skeleton Key gives us 99 keys. It's hard to pass that up. Even if keys aren't necessarily all that useful, right now anyway. Secret room might be below here. By the way, we just passed 15,200 members on our Invictus subreddit, which is just awesome. I can't believe how far the subreddit has come, so thank you all very much for checking out our subreddit. It's a lot of fun. We got lots of good discussions, we got lots of good memes of the day, and that's the best way for you to get your meme of the day. What's going on with this? I don't like him. All right, you gotta go, bro. Oh, I can run them into the fire. Well, that makes it a lot easier. To range up. we might as well bomb the mines now before I forget and accidentally use one of our bombs for like something else. Now, one of the biggest flaws that I had playing as the Forgotten was the fact, and this is something that people pointed out, was that I need to be switching to the soul a lot more. Why switch to the soul? Well, because you can do this. So the soul is the secondary character attached to the Forgotten, and it has the more traditional attack. Plus, you've got spectral tears, not piercing tears, but you've got spectral tears, and that can be quite good. On top of that, you can also completely avoid any damage on your red hearts in case if you happen to have more soul hearts than red heart containers. Right now, we don't, of course, but it doesn't really matter because we're about to turn into the Lost, which we are right now. Okay, so the lost Forgotten does indeed have a bone. We're gonna go get the knife piece here, and then we gotta decide whether or not we're gonna go fight the boss. We don't have any backup plan against the boss right now. Like we can't exactly go into, if we go in there, we die, basically. We can only take two hits. And this movement speed does kind of worry me a little bit. As you saw there, we can't even get out of the way of a normal shot. This is going to be nerve-wracking. Okay, never mind. Okay. Oh, we can still switch to the soul. All right, so Rainmaker. I don't know what he's doing. You see here, I'm using the Forgotten here to shield the soul. We were able to kill him. Unfortunately, we got Mom's. Well, maybe not, unfortunately. Let's see. I'm drowsy. Well, health doesn't do anything for us. Shot speed down. and bad gas. All right. Well, I mean, we got an extra item. I guess we can be happy about that. We also got Swallowed Penny, which might help us out a little bit, I suppose. Could have been worse. Definitely could have been worse. We could go into this. We could go into the curse room. We can go check out the challenge room as well. Just need to be careful. Big Chub doing big work over there. See you, Big Chub. I see you. Okay. Never mind. All right. We got one card. We got one key piece. Yeah, I mean, we got another mom item, I guess. That's something. Sure. We can actually get into the curse room for half price. Simply walking in and then using the soul, to get out. Another full health pill. Luck up pill. Sure. Actually, we can go. Let's go out as the Forgotten, because this way here, we can get the half red heart and recover it. There we go. As you saw me right there, you can pick up health pickups and anything really, as long if the bone has enough range to hit something you're trying to pick up, then Isaac will automatically pick it up. We will head on down to the mines. Okie dokie. First time in the mines as the Forgotten. Again, this movement speed does worry me quite a bit. So will we use the D8? Yeah, sure, why not? Okay, we got our movement speed back. We actually gained damage? We lost our tier delay big time. Yeah. That tier delay got shot all down. Damage is still decent. So we're going to go back in here again as the Forgotten, just because we have this red heart. You saw me pick it up right there. So our range is quite nice, but our damage, our DPS, I should say, is no bueno right now. Yeah, we get a whole lot of movement speed and tears rate, but we lost some damage and a lot of range. Yeah, our movement speed's way too fast right now. I mean, it's not way too fast, but we're definitely a lot faster. Infestation, okay. That's the dangers of taking the D8. What am I doing? I saw that heart and thought it was below me. We should go try to find the store. You get infestation, which is gonna spawn an attack fly every time we take damage. Apparently there's one still alive. Okay. There we go. Check out challenge room. I don't think we need it. Alright, we gained a whole lot of damage and range. We lost about half of our movement speed. But we gained a lot of damage again. Tears rate still looking okay. Yeah, we actually had a net gain of damage here. Whoa, I don't know how we split that up right, but that was kinda crazy. Need to be careful here with pride. A little bit surprised that we haven't seen any red heart upgrades yet, but you see, we're still thumping away on these champions and mobs. And the Forgotten does do a lot of damage. Like, there's no denying it. It's a finesse character, I would say. See here, we're just absolutely crushing enemies. I'm willing to stay with this for a little bit. We'll go ahead and take the easy route there. Thank you very much. See that we can actually open up chests as well just by whacking at it. On transformation moon card. But again, this movement speed kind of worries me. Especially in Repentance, where everything is faster, you've got to be on your toes here. So we may or may not be switching this. Let's see how we do against the boss. Oh, it's going to be great, Gideon. So for those of you who have not seen this boss yet, Great Gideon is a wave-based boss, which has waves, and six of them to be exact. You can't actually damage Gideon, but he essentially, or it will essentially, throw everything at that you can at random. It's so think of it sort of like mini greed is the best way to describe it. This is mini greed mode right here. A bad wave. See, your flying makes things easy. Easier, I should say. Okay. Gonna get meat. Did get another devil deal. And a bone heart. And a Krampus fight. I'm gonna switch to the soul here because I don't want to lose the bone heart. If we can get the head of Krampus, that'd be good. We did get the head of Krampus. The head of Krampus has been reverted back to its original 3-room cooldown cost, which is pretty darn. That's strong. I said it even in the interview with Edmund that the original Krampus's head. So a lot of Isaac players probably don't even remember the original Krampus's head, but it is now the original Krampus's head. So that's pretty darn awesome. We have a semi-boss killer. We've got, pretty good damage here. And we just gained some HP. Our soul is completely full HP. So, I mean, we're not going to get cocky, but this is starting to look a little promising. All right, we're on Ash Pit. Got to look for the three golden buttons. What? What's I say about that? Okay, well, here's the mine cart with the golden buttons. There's one. Good AoE damage there. Wow. Okay. The Swallow Penny just gave us a dime. And we'll take that. We can even bomb our way into the challenge room now. For some reason, there's a cracked key here. The crack key can be used for a variety of different things. We do have a moon card. Okay, so we can teleport out of here. The moon. The crack key can open up red doors, and I don't know if they appear normally. Oh, they do. Okay. So we are in a red room right now. And it goes to a, it goes to the super secret room. I don't know if that's the actual super secret room or not. And that is the bloody key, I think it's called. Honestly, I think I want to stick with Krampus. Well, we do have 99 keys. I believe that the bloody key uses keys as current or as ammunition. I think I've only had it once, and I don't. I mean, it wasn't that long ago, but I've already forgot. Oh, yep. Tried to run out of the way too fast and got stuck on the rock. Let's take, I mean, we can afford to take the bloody key. And let's just see. Sharp key, sorry. And let's see how well it does against this boss. Remember, we still have to go get the other key piece, so this is not a we're not done yet. I could go for the key piece, but let's do this first. The pile. Good block there by Big Chubb. Get a range upgrade. What is, that's a little abandoned. Look at the dead as well. Never seen little Abba Dabba Ding Dong. We know that Mom's knife is quite good with the Forgotten. Kind of want to see what little Abaddon does. Against my better judgment. Missile friend. Oh, okay. So the little Abaddon does the Maw of the Void effect. Very interesting. I wonder if he can spawn Black Soul Hearts from that. Probably not, is my guess. If regular Maw can't do it, then I would be shocked if they let a mini Maw do it. Damage is looking quite nice now. Airfront car, we'll get that back. Warfly. People said the Warfly isn't the, I guess the Locust doesn't hit Isaac anymore or something. Yeah, we there by a little Abaddon. Spider Bite, we'll take Spider Bite. Can't help myself. Yeah, so we can't really afford to lose his HP here. Then we can go into the first room to get the other soul heart. We might as well. Well, I guess we might as well wait because we're going to. Undoubtedly, we're going to lose HP here. I just don't want to lose. I do not want to lose our bone hearts. Bone hearts are the most important thing to us right now. So as much of a cakewalk as flying makes this run here. We're still, like, obviously we're going to be tethered to the Forgotten, so we can't exactly just fly away like Azazel did. All right, and away we go. Try to goad her to go that way, and then we go this way. I may have been able to make it out the door there. Oh gosh, this is gonna be horrible. I was gonna try to cut the corner there, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to. Okay, we made it. Made it without getting hit. That's not easy to do. But I'll take my little victory there. Okay, I think we're going to not go with the sharp key. Even though we have lots of keys, it didn't seem like it does a whole lot of damage. I didn't mean to buy that, but yeah, I think the head of Krampus just makes more sense. So we're going to tap this. And then we can tap it again with the soul. There we go. Look at all the flies we have thanks to Infestation 1. Let's go back and pick up some red hearts. And we'll go pick up that last soul heart inside of the secret room, so that way the mausoleum didn't cost us anything. We do need to be kind of cautious with our HP, though, obviously. We've got full HP on the soul, but not with the forgotten. So, yeah. But our damage is still quite good, and we have Mom's Knife. That's something to remember, especially since we're going to be probably switching to the soul here for the majority of the next few levels. Eternal Heart's pretty darn pog here, I gotta say. And there it goes. Fortunately. What in the world is that? Psyfly. Flamboyant Hector. Okay. Got a luck upgrade there. Now, flying is something I wish we had by default here on this run. I mean, really on any run, but little abba dabba ding dong. Let's see you get some flies. Yeah, you know what? It doesn't do too bad of damage, I gotta say. You gotta love the scythe at the end of the Forgotten Club. All right, let's see who our boss is. Be the heretic. What in the world? Oh. I've never seen the heretic before, but apparently the heretic starts completely invulnerable and does that after it dies, okay? Mausoleum 1, we don't... Yeah, I mean, we have nothing to go on, so I guess we just go head on down. In Gehenna now. There's no going back, and here's the hoping that we can find a little... I mean, we haven't found a single bone heart in this run. Eternal Heart went to the soul. So what I'm trying to get at is that having 2 HP versus Mother is going to be, let's just call it fascinating. Farting baby, he farts. Fantastic. So So we can find one red heart. We can basically get into the curse room. Just tended rock in here. Yep, that's absolutely a good use of Krampus's head there. I think that we get one more. This is our final shop, I believe. I don't know what just happened in this room, but it wasn't intentional. I can assure you that. Magician card, sure. Okay. We don't need more soul hearts right now. What we really need to find is our shop. Hopefully it's a good shop. What will we take over the head of Krampus? I mean, one of the candles I wouldn't be opposed to. You always tell when those little brimstone guys are gonna fire at you because they start moving in sync with Isaac. Very nice. Oh, the spikes kill things? Okay. So we can't go fight. Can I go fight the boss yet? I want to find our item room. Our item room, by item room, I mean item shop. Soul heart there, because we do take damage. We might as well take it on the soul heart. We can now, thanks to the red hearts, we can now get into the curse room. Let's go do that real quick. Stars card. Could have teleported out of there, but I'd rather... I mean, there's no real reason for me to save it, actually, now that I think about it. Never mind. So what this is going to come down to is basically our damage outweighing the lack of movement speed against Mother, if we make it to Mother. I'm still not convinced that we'll actually make it to Mother. Okay, well, that's not true. I think we will. I just don't think that it's going to go well. T forever, okay. Damn, is there another soul heart? Fortunately, we don't need soul hearts. Tinted rock in here. That makes things easy. PH Dizzle. Heart plug, sure. As well buy all the things. You know what? We can even put some money back in. We go on the keeper. Honestly, I think the full health might actually be more appropriate for us having only 2 HP. We need to make sure we don't lose that bone heart. But if worse comes to worst, at the very, very, very least, we'll still have, you know, one extra heart to heal up with. And let's assume that we don't get any more HP upgrades, which we probably won't. Good damage there with the head of Krampus. Almost did the brimstone on us. And the that room's already open for some reason. Oof, man. Damage would be pretty darn nice. But at the cost of 1 HP, I think we have enough damage. Excuse me, game. The knife was in and now it's not. We had the knife. It must have, I guess, stabbed the door. It stabbed the door before we went into Devil Deal, and then the door didn't stay open. Wow. All right. The blind. Well, that is unfortunate, because with the mom's knife run, I mean, we had a solid run. Whoa, what is this fly doing? It's going in just absolutely ham. So yeah, so that really, really sucks, because we had a good run going. And apparently, even though we opened the door, albeit accidentally, with the knife, apparently it will close up again if you're not careful, or if you go into the item room. So I guess if you open, the rule of thumb will now be, if you open up the, if you're going into the mother fight, then make sure you don't stab the door accidentally, prematurely. And if you do, go straight down. Otherwise, if you go into a Devil Deal, you're going to lose it. That's a little bit annoying, because obviously we had a good thing going here. I think we'll stay in forgotten form, or soul form here. We got our full charge back on Head of Krampus, and I mean, we got 99 keys. Will the keybagger actually give something pretty halfway decent or what? We got a range upgrade and master lockpicking. But again, we have 91 keys, so I don't think we really need master lockpicking. I'd rather have. Hey, the Warfly seems to have been doing pretty good work for us. What is this? Oh, Jawbreaker. That's the one that spits out. It's kind of like Tough Love in a way. Damage there. Man, this fly is going nuts. The psionic protector or whatever he is. Going ham. Look at that. I mean, just okay, well, I mean, you didn't do anything there, but yeah, it just goes right after any projectiles. I'm happy now that we decided to keep this full health pill. Whoop. That was not shoop whoop. You pretend, okay? My god! My god! Okie dokie. I think that we just go on in. So we're not gonna get an unlocking. Yeah, we're not gonna unlock in. We're not going to get an unlock for the Forgotten today, because again, a little snafu, a little problem with the handoff there, going on into where we're supposed to be going. Yeah, no, I don't think it's. I mean, Curse of the Blind. No, thank you. But if anything, this can serve as a sort of like a learning experience that we don't want to stab. We don't want to accidentally stab the front door if we're not trying to. And if we do, make sure you don't go into the devil deal, because you will lose your everything. You will lose not only the key pieces, but also like basically the whole reason for us to be doing this run. But now it's kind of like, okay, we're gonna get some Forgotten practice with try out the head of Krampus, see how everyone adjusts to it, that sort of thing. Oh, you're alive. I didn't know you were alive. Black Death is no bueno. And I accidentally used our full health pill when I was trying to switch to the soul. Pretty good about that. Feel pretty pogged out about that. I wanted to see how many shots. Because like, it's inconsequential, right? If we take damage right now on the Forgotten, because we got the red heart on the ground. I mean, I'm not gonna try to take damage, of course, because like that's just risky. But, it's not as risky as you may think it is. Just because of the fact that we can just fill them back up. Warfly has been killing it, love it. World. Oh yeah. That thing. Let's go back and go grab that red heart again. We're not going to take any we're not going to take any unnecessary risks to our HP here. Cuz I really don't want to see a negative win streak counter after just barely losing yesterday's run, which if you haven't seen the conclusion of that run, stop what you're doing. Like pause this run and go watch that one, cuz that one is We go from thinking that we're like unstoppable to, oh, we're not. One of those kind of runs. But I mean, it was a fantastic run, dude. I didn't even see that fly. We need to be ultra careful here, not get a full health. No. Oh yeah, that's what that does. Also, what are we doing? Go back and get that red heart for the love of God. All right, so we're kind of living dangerously here with our HP, but we just got Brimstone, which is going to be very, very nice. Keeping me safe and the soul safe as well. As we can attack from afar, though we do, I mean, the range on Brimstone with the Forgotten is not what I would say is ideal, but it's serviceable because at least you can walk stuff into the little vortex that you create. But man, this would have been great to take over into the mother fight.
Oh,
Okay. This would be interesting here against Isaac. Oh wow, I didn't finish him off. There we go. Alright, we're gonna head on up, but man, it's gonna be dicey. It's gonna be spicy up here. We need to get an HP upgrade bad. Curse of Lost. I don't know what the heck those are. None of these are anything. Quince, they lurk inside. We get conjoined. Okay. All right, let's go see. Let's just see if we can do it. Our movement speed. I don't know what these things are. They're like little shadow babies or something. What? Oh, there's creep up there. Lover's card could not have. And that would come at a better time. Thought about it, and I was like, you know what? We're only at 1 HP. And yeah, there's a lot of stuff going on the screen right now, so yeah. What the heck are these? They're like, are they stationary? It looks like they're just kind of just sitting there shooting on their own. One big old bat dead end. All right. All righty. Let's see what's up here. Wow, that thing actually took a hit from. Careful. Eternal Heart's gonna be pretty big here. I don't think Parasite does anything, but might as well try it. Blood Rites, yeah. Wish. Yeah, we're just going to go for HP here. Isn't it funny how much we've gone from like, oh, we don't want HP to, yeah, we need HP. Spawning little brimstones. Yeah, why not? Skinny out mushroom gives us a pretty significant movement speed up. Tears up as well, of course. Gotta run stuff into brimstone. There we go. When you combine that melee damage with the brimstone damage, that is just brutal. Oh. Okay. There goes our half heart. We do get Scorpio, which is going to give us poisoning attacks, which I heard are really darn good in Repentance now as well. I'm hearing a lot of things about Repentance. Get the Hourglass, which is kind of tempting, to be honest. Is that Super Envy? That is Super Envy. Super Dead. What's up here? I don't know. But yeah, I mean, it was a nice little refresher for the Forgotten. It had been a very, very, very long time since I played them. But the fact that we, you know, the fact that we didn't get a... I'd use the full health now. I don't want to lose this. I do not want to lose this heart container. Also, the first time I've seen the adversary as well. A little bit, a little bit. Okay, give me another dead end here. Good. Crack the skizzle. Yeah, you know what? We'll try to crack the skizzle. Crack the sky, but that's a fun one with Bethany. Blood rights, I bet that is. You know, I bet that one is probably fun with Bethany. Fun with Bethany. Yeah, there goes Limehorn again. And another dead end. All right. Looking solid, coach. Finally get another soul heart here. We get Sister Maggie to join the follower of Conga line. And we get to head all the way back down and hopefully this time around go to the real direction that we need to go into. All right. Crack the skizzle. Oh, I love that new effect. Love the sound effects. Not sure what those babies are doing over there, but they ain't shooting in the right direction. Oh, now they are. There's a dark one. And another dead end. How does he do it? Well, we now get to go into the... Okay. Apparently, it's just all dead ends. All right, everyone. Well, no blue baby on this floor, apparently. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Dude, I have no idea where we haven't been. Let's see. We've been up here. We did the full circle. Did we go over here? Did we go up here? Yeah, that's where we came from. Did we go all the way up here? It appears we did. Yep. Okay. Oh boy. Oh, this is a... Oh, there it is. We were there. We just didn't go all the way down. I gotcha. So yeah, so we are going to get a win here as the Forgotten. At least I think we are anyway. It's unfortunate that we did not get the lead pencil. You're just in time. It's unfortunate that we didn't get an unlock for the Forgotten. That would have been cool. But c'est la vie. Now we know. Now we know that if you have the knife piece, don't accidentally stab the red door. Because if you do, you got to commit to it. You can't go into a devil deal. So food for thought for next time. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Hey, look at that. We got a Forgotten Rundown. It's been a long time since you see me play as that character. So hopefully you enjoyed it. As always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Glenn McKenzie, Enigmatic Unicorn, Paul, Daniel Lynch, and Austin Parente. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then go check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at www.patreon.com/Sinvicta.